just play the damn thing.
So recently, a viewer asked me about, about what would be my top five pedals that I would put on a compact pedal board. So I decided to take a step further and just do a video on it. Now, here's what I have here, and I'll go through each of these pedals individually. But they're all sitting on this pedal board right here. This is the Guido GPB01B, I believe. You know, I think they make three sizes. This is the smallest one. And as you can see, it comes with not just its own carry bag, but this is a nice carry bag. I did a video on this pedal board here a while back. So I will post that up here in the card as well as down in the description so that you can go check out that video if you want, because this video, this pedal board, you know, despite the fact that it's got a really, really stupid name, for a pedal board brand, it's actually a really, really good pedal board. You can find them on Amazon. They're sold by the same people that, they're sold by the Joyo Direct Amazon store. So, they're the ones that sent this to me. And, just a brief overview. Again, I go into more detail on this on the actual video on this pedal board, but, it uses these little bitty, I don't even know what you call them, clips, whatever, I guess, that, they just mount right onto the pedal board on either side of the pedal and hold it in place, just one little screw per clip as it's resting up against the pedal, and there's the screws that it comes with. I don't necessarily understand the science behind it, but it works, I put a bunch of pedals on this thing, held it upside down and shook it around and all kinds of stuff, and it didn't move. So, brief overview on that. Again, if you want more detail, go check out the pedal board, go check out the video itself. Just wanted to show you everything that the board comes with. I don't know what the dimensions are here. It's probably, 16 inches wide, I guess, give or take. This camera here kind of give you a little bit better angle of it that you can get an idea. Now, compact is the name of the game here. So, the viewer in question asked me, top five pedals. That's a tough pedal board for me to build because, unless it's a gig that, it's like a real short gig that I know I'm only going to need very specific effects or at very specific points or something like that. At that point, I would probably just narrow it down to a tuner, overdrive, phaser or chorus delay or something like that, and let the amp do the rest of the work. But here in this instance, I decided that, compact being the name of the game, I would try to squeeze as much onto this board as I possibly could. So first things first, and if we're going by our standard pedal board order of operations, and that is typically how I set up my pedal boards, tuner is the first thing in the chain. And this is the original TC Electronic Polytune. I should probably upgrade this at some point, and they do have a mini version of this out now, but this is the very first version of the Polytune that came out. I bought it since, I've owned this thing since it came out, and it's never let me down. So, I guess that's probably the reason why I haven't replaced it, but it is small enough that it should fit on here. Okay. So next in the chain is where I usually put my wah pedal. And the wah pedal that I'm going with here in this instance is the Bad Horsey Wah from Morley's new 2020 series. Basically, it's basically a more compact version of the older Steve Vai Bad Horsey 2 contour wah. So, spring loaded foot switch on it, which I like on wah pedals. A couple of other, there's a contour knob, a late and a level knob and a contour wah switch, and there's all kinds of cool stuff in here. I've done videos just about all these pedals actually, but wah pedals are getting smaller and smaller these days. This one's not quite as small as the Dunlop Mini stuff that's out now, but it's pretty close, and for this pedal board it should be fine. Actually seems to fit front to back almost perfectly. Next, need an overdrive pedal. I almost went with the Spark Booster, mini booster that is, as my overdrive, and I changed my mind and went a different direction. This one's still on the board, but I'll, again, a little bit different, and I'll explain this here in a bit. So again, compact, miniature size being the name of the game here. Needed a small overdrive pedal. So the Tube Screamer TS Mini is the one that is the one that won this battle. You know, of all the tube screamers, that you know, the TS Mini, it's basically a miniature version of the TS-808 or the TS-808 reissue, technically. You know, of all the different tube screamers that Ivan has put out over the year, this one's probably not my favorite, but you know, for the purposes of just using it as an overdrive, you know, as an overdrive boost or something like that, again, it's just fine. It will do the job. Distortion. This was a really difficult one for me to choose because, you know, the fact that I was trying to keep this to keep this compact and small as possible eliminated the great big options like the Amp Tweaker Type Metal Pro, the new X Fireman distortion, you know, stuff like that. Big, you know, bigger, larger size pedals, you know, and really even a lot of standard size stomp box. Even the Boss stuff wasn't going to work in this instance. So I decided to go with the Tone City Golden Plexi. This is actually one of my favorite. It's one of my favorite distortions because it's in my top two favorite Marshall in a box style distortions. The other favorite, ironically, is also a Tone City pedal. Basically, the bigger version of this called the Model M, but again, compact. I decided to go with this one for size being one reason, but more importantly, just because of its overall versatility. That gain knob right there in the middle, wherever that thing is positioned, you can get all kinds of sounds out of this thing. And regardless of what amp I'm using, you know, if it's going into a clean channel, you know, it's just going to give me that much more versatility because I generally do prefer to just use the amp distortion, particularly at gigs, but you know, there's times that I want a different tone, you know, and that's why I generally keep a distortion pedal or two on my board. And speaking of or two, I wanted to make sure and give myself a little bit more versatility tone-wise. So I decided to include the Electro-Harmonix Flatiron Fuzz. And if you're not familiar with this pedal, this is the pedal that changed my mind about rat circuits. I used to hate rat pedals. You know, I couldn't stand them because they're basically just, you know, glorified fuzzes to me. You know, they're but I discovered with this thing that, what, you know, it's a rat, but this thing for whatever reason made me discover that if you dial it in just right, it's actually a really cool, nasty, gnarly sound and high gain distortion. And it doesn't have to be, you know, because it kind of walks the line between fuzz and distortion, so it doesn't have to cross the line over into fuzz territory if you don't want it to, which I normally don't. But like, you can always crank it up if you need it to. So in the event that I would need a fuzz, that one would likely fill the void there for me. That's everything that I would run into the front of the amp. Now what about the effects loop? Well, that's what these four pedals here are going to be about. And starting with, again, as I mentioned earlier, going back to the Spark Mini Booster. Why is this one in the effects loop? Because I think one of the coolest things that you can do for a solo boost is a clean boost of some kind in the effects loop. I typically like to use an EQ pedal, but you know, again, trying to remain compact and spaces at a premium, I'm going to go with the Spark Mini Booster for that purpose. So that's the only thing that this thing's going to be set up for, a clean boost in the effects loop, specifically for solo boosts. That's what it does. You know, not meant to tighten up amps or anything like that. That's what this tube screamer is going to do. You know, so not meant to tighten up any kind of high gain, other kind of high gain tones or anything. Strictly a clean solo boost. For phaser, I like phasers. I've played in a lot of cover bands, and just about every one of them has played Ain't Talking About Love, which means I've got to have a good phaser handy. Tough to beat. You know, this is not my choice just because it's a miniature size pedal, but because I think it's the best phaser that MXR has put out to this day. This is the MXR Phase 90. So very, very, very versatile. It's basically kind of like four different MXR phase pedals all in one box. And I happen to love it. So gonna use this. They have another compact phaser out now, I think called the Deep Phase or something like that. I need to pick that one up just to see what the difference is between the two. I'm sure this one will probably remain my favorite, but the other one has my curiosity. But for these purposes, I'm going with Phase 95. For chorus pedal, we are going with this here pedal that I just demoed recently. This is the new X pedal out of their new mini core series. They call it the SCF. or the mini Super Chorus is what it's called, which is basically a miniature clone of the old TC Electronic SCF chorus pedal that was they're famous for back in the 80s. Those things go for a lot of money now. You know, they go for a lot of money. And this thing actually has three different, it's got three different effects in one, and I can control it all with one switch. So, you know, it has the ability to also to convert to flanger and pitch modulation should I ever need those effects as well. I've got them here in this box. So, but primary purpose for this, though, would be for chorus, which I use chorus on clean tones often. And last but not least, I just demoed this pedal the other day. This is the new Walrus Audio delay pedal out of their new Fundamental series. Walrus Audio recently came out with these pedals because, you know, they're a high-end pedal company, and they wanted to give people an option to buy something in the $100 range. You know, so all these Fundamental series pedals all cost about between $100 and $129 bucks. You know, this is, you know, delay pedals are obviously some of the more expensive ones, so this is the one of the 129 varieties, but this thing does a ton. It's got three different delay modes in it. You can do digital, analog, or reverse delay, you know, and it's got a tap tempo feature, again, all on one switch. Somehow it just knows, you know, you hold the button in for, you hold the switch in for tap tempo mode, and then once you're in tap tempo mode and you got your tempo selected, you can also select one of three different division modes down here on the bottom, which is like hold dot an eighth and or half dot an eighth and slap back or something like that. I can't remember, but three different division modes to choose from once you have it in tap tempo mode. And then you take it out of tap tempo mode and you're back to you're back to your three different delay modes. Anyway, so a lot of versatility in a delay pedal with one switch, and actually a little bit smaller than a standard stomp box size. Not quite miniature sized, but in this instance, it's pretty darn close. So that's why it's going to go right there. You know, and if this dead space right here is driving you crazy, that's, you know, I'm leaving that open because that's where I would mount a power supply of some kind. You know, as far as what power supply I would use, these are all 9-volt pedals, so it wouldn't be anything too crazy. I might even get away with using a one spot for all of these. You know, again, just to eliminate that headache, and then I could stick a couple more pedals in here, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. I'd be one pedal over for the one spot. So, and regardless, it's usually better to use an independent power supply anyway. So if I were going to build a compact pedal board right this second, these are some of the choices that I would probably make and what I would use to build said pedal board. You might also notice the way that I have it laid out. You know, these five pedals here, tuner, wah, overdrive, distortion, and distortion fuzz, whatever that one is. You know, all my dirt pedals, you know, these all go into the front of the amp, right? So, you know, for cable logistics, it might even make sense to go that way with it. So that this just, you know, so that the amp output goes, you know, it stays out of the way of all this madness going on here. So all this stuff here going into the front of the amp, and then of course these four pedals here would go into the effects loop, is how I would cable that. So there you go. You asked for my opinion, that's what I would do. Let me know how you would go about building a compact pedal board down below. I would love to read about it. Adios.